Biologics Production Facility is a multifunctional laboratory. It's a production facility, which means our main purpose is to manufacture cellular therapy products that will be given to patients. We can assist researchers in scaling up their research ideas into a usable product, and we can also manufacture other things for a biotech company. We also process fairly routine products that we give to patients every day in the marrow and stem cell transplant program.
Jointly operated by the Nebraska Medical Center, the region's largest hospital, and the University of Nebraska Medical Center, the state's health science center, and an international leader in health research, the Biologics Production Facility opens new frontiers in research and patient care. In just a few hours, this liquid, known as storage media, will be part of someone's cancer treatment.
We'll put a little bit of the storage media in there and then we'll take it over to the patient. So then they'll get those cells as part of their treatment for their cancer. So it's a pretty neat little system.
The methods used here bring the concept of personalized medicine to an entirely new level.
This laboratory makes that kind of benchtop to bedside translation possible because we can take what is essentially a research product and make it according to good manufacturing principles so that we can actually safely administer it to a patient. The vaccine or the cellular product can be manufactured just for you, so it can be targeted just against your malignancy, for example, or the kind of problem that you have.
It's no ordinary laboratory. Every room and every piece of equipment here was specially designed, built, and installed with absolute cleanliness in mind.
The air in a standard laboratory wouldn't necessarily be controlled, because the standard laboratory tests that you do don't really require that you have particularly clean air. The air in this facility in some portions is 100 times or more cleaner than an operating room. There are filters at each entrance to every room. If we have any open steps in processing, we do those under a biologic safety cabinet, which is very, very clean. The reason for that is that these are all products that patients are going to get. They're going to get an infusion or an injection, and we have to be very certain that nothing contributes to contaminating these or cross-contaminating one product with somebody else's product. All these products are unique, one product to one patient. So it's not like a bank or a laboratory where you would have many units of blood, for example, in a blood bank, and you would just cross-match them and give them to an appropriate patient. These are specifically designated one product to one patient.
As a facility, it has various classifications. We have class 100,000, we have class 10,000, our two main processing suites. There is unique materials that are used. The GMP guidelines state that we have to have materials in place from the lights to the paints to the flooring that are all cleanable and prohibit contaminations. There's nothing that can get in from exterior spaces, from the wall spaces, ceiling spaces, etc. It's completely sealed. The only thing that's supplied to this room is the air from the HEPA filtered air handlers and then of course the exhaust.
Right now, patients undergoing stem cell and bone marrow transplants for certain types of leukemia and lymphoma are directly benefiting from the Biologics Production Facility.
I think this facility takes us to the next level in all of those areas. It takes marrow and stem cell transplant to the next level of being able to use not only the transplant, but the immune therapy or the other things that go with it to make outcomes better or to decrease complications. Or to treat diseases that were resistant before.
New ground is being broken in the area of solid organ transplant as well.
Not every organ that is available for transplant is suitable for transplant. Some of those could be used for making a suspension of the cells that are important in that organ, and that's really the next step. And it also would allow that if we could grow these things up or if we could split an organ because we had a small recipient, or in other ways just manipulate things, it allows us to take that next step.
When it comes to the future, the sky's the limit.
Hopefully in the future we'll be able to do more new things. I think the standard products that we've been making for a long time are very helpful for many patients, but that's not really the future of transplantation or of immune therapies. And I see that there'll be a lot more diseases that could be treated with products or vaccines that could be manufactured here. And I think it's pretty much limitless.